of the ledge and let me take your picture.
Turn it up.
show you how it goes.
Do you?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, show the love, show the love. That's what I'm talking about. Pelican Cove. gentlemen, boys and girls, show some love, show some love, show some love. That's what I'm talking about. Each and every Monday, Palms of Credit and Code. That's how we do it. Boys and girls, show some love, show the love. Nice.
Move it.
gentlemen. Give it up.
All right, I'm going to give you guys a quick history here. Everything you see here before you, this was a sugar cane and cotton plantation in the 1700s. We had several plantations here on St. Croix, and each plantation had their own name. This one already was called a state dam. It's like the state dam and 5-year dark Cougeron, right? Now, Cougeron was established in the 1760s, and the first owner of Cougeron was the Nelthorpe family. Today, for the Nelthorpe family, who we have is Donnie Nelthorpe. He's a master blender. We have Gary Nelthorpe. He's the president of Cougeron. And back to the women, we have Karen Nelthorpe. She's my boss. As of 7 to 8 years ago, though, Jimmy from Kentucky, he bought Cougeron. Then about 2 years now, Suntory, the Japanese whiskey company, they bought half of Jimmy, which now is no longer called Jimmy. It's now called the Suntory. All right, now this green building right here, this back then was a plantation owner's home, right? It was called Great House. It was a one level, but then they refurbished it and made it into a two level home. Today, this building is the executive office. Right over there, we see the Cougeron sign, that two-story building. That was a carriage house, which is storing carriages. Today, they no longer have carriages there. They use the building for training, which they do safety as well as tastings of the rum. So when we come back in here and clean up afterwards, there'd be no rum inside of the cups, okay? So you know what it was. Now right over here, this looks like a garage, but it's not. Okay, it was a stable back then, but it had the horses and the donkeys. Today, what they use it for is basically to place vows in here after it's been used for 36 years. Now just so you guys know, they don't age the rum for that amount of time. They just use the vows for that amount of time. Well, they place the vows here, they sell it for $40. Anybody that would buy it, they would probably like cut it in half, that conjures and cheers out of it. Or like if you've seen it in the beaches, they make the tables. Alright? Now how many of you guys know what this stone structure is? No?
Sugar mill,
that's right. We had like about 115 of these on the island back then. Some of them have gotten destroyed during hurricanes, so we have less of them today. So if you were to build a house where there is one on land, you can't destroy it. You have to leave it as is. What some people have done though, they got creative. They either built their house with it, or if not, go to the east side of the island. There's actually one house that actually the top part of it, they've made a pool in the top of it. Right? They got very creative. All right? So, the top part, notice, looks like something is missing. They used to have the windmill on top of it. And the inside, it had two rollers that rotated left-right motion while the windmill was spinning. And what they did is they threw in the sugar cane in here, which when the rollers rotate, they crush the sugar cane juice in the sugar cane. And what they did with the juice, they boil it, turn it into a brown thing substance, which is called molasses. And that's one of the three ingredients we use in our rum. The other two is yeast and water. That's all you need to make rum. Alright? Alright? Now right here we have the seven flags, six of them which once owned St. Croix. Today we are U.S. Below the U.S. we have the Virgin Islands flag. First flag you see here is Spain, then Great Britain, then France. Last three to the end we have Scotland, Denmark, and Knights of Malta. The days of the last before the U.S. was on the Virgin Islands, and they sold the Virgin Islands to the U.S. for $25 million gold. Up to this day, we do have a lot of Danish come here. They do the tours. They love the fact that we have in Frederiksted, instead of the island, we still have the signs up with the Danish language, as well as in Christiansted. We have a Danish hotel, which is pretty awesome. We've been meaning to go there sometime, Alright, now before we do head on to the next part of the tour, I'm just going to let you guys in on some safety rules. We are a functional facility, we do have cars going up and down, so just remain to the side of the road. There are some uneven cracks in the road, so watch your step, and we do have to go up some stairs, so hold on to the handrails as we do. Alright, so you guys ready to go? And you're more than welcome to take photos too. Here. All right. So
No. No, it's coming off the this truck. It's not hot.
It is super sweet. And we received two types of molasses. High test molasses and black trap molasses. Black trap might be a little bit more like a, you might get a malt kind of taste with it. But the high test molasses is much more sweeter. It has a taste of like, you know, the Cracker Jack, caramel for the Cracker Jack. Anytime I have it, that's what it reminds me of. Yep. Put that on some pancakes, right?
Oh yeah, that's
it's
good.
So sweet. All right. You guys ready to go?
Yeah. All right, just so you guys know, the top and the bottom part of this logo, that's the Nelthorpe family crest, okay? They used it on the Crujerum logo. They added the Crujerum in the middle. As for the first bottles, that was made, they had the logo, which was a sail ship. That's what it was in the beginning. As for the first flavored rum, which was a citrus, it was a gecko. And that's the only flavored rum that was aged. Just so you guys know, it was aged about 6 months to a year. So it's like 35% alcohol, and the rest flavored rums that weren't aged at all, 21%. All right?
What was the family?
Nelthorpe. After the last 12 years, that's it. They don't use it anymore. If you look at 2009 barrels, it starts seeping through the wood. Then the wood would definitely get bent during the being there for a long time. All right? Now our barrels, we received them from Jim Beam. Jim Beam only uses the barrels once for bourbon whiskey. And when we receive the barrels, what we do is we pressure steam the inside of the barrel, taking out what we call the devil's cut, which is what Jim Beam charred the inside of the barrels. All right, once we've done that, we put 1 pound of oak chips inside of each barrel, all right, fill it up with the distilled product, pop in a new bottle, put a fresh coat of white paint, set the month and a year, and leave it there to sit in it. All right? Now this is the only warehouse we bring our guests because of the two ways they place the bowls. This was the old way they placed the bowls, which I used to think was bed frames, but they're not. These are actually Caribbean railroad trucks. You just roll the bowls in here, leave them there to sit in age. Never rotate it because it's not wine. So only difference from back then, it was laid down to the side, which took up much more space like this. As of today, they're standing upward and they're on pallets. Much easier for the men to use the forklift to carry 9 at a time to the dumping truck. Yes. Now right here, these are examples of the barrel. Alright, this is after it's been distilled, the 189.9, but they bring it down to 142 with natural rainwater. Once they've done that, they use this one for the flavored rums as well as the place in the barrel. So after it's been in the barrel for 2 years, it changes into an amber color. After 5 years, it's much more darker. After 12 years, way darker. Now besides the color changing for the aging process, what else happens is that it actually evaporates. We call that the angel share bite. All right? Nobody knows what's going on. All right. They're sneaking off with it. So after 12 years, it's like probably like a quarter of the barrel. So we don't sell it straight up like that. It would be way too expensive. So what we do is we take the 5 year and the 8 year, we blend it with a 12 year, put it back in the barrel for 6 months to a year, and we call that the single barrel, okay? Which is has like a butterscotch taste to it. It's really smooth. There's also the 5 year steak diamond dark that has more of an oaky flavor to it, and it's smooth as well. As for the 5 year steak diamond light, it was the dark 5 year, but they filtered it. But the crazy thing about it is that once you taste it, it's actually much more stronger. As the two darts are actually not strong, they're really smooth, really, okay? And we also have a 2 to 4 year age rum that has molasses added back into it. That's a black strap rum. With that one, you could use it to marinate your meat. You could put it as a floater in any of your drink inside your barbecue sauce, okay? Which is really good, all right? That goes good as well in your velvet sink, which, ladies, I'm sure you're gonna love. You love rum chata, you're gonna love the horchata with rum, which is the velvet zin, which is 15% alcohol. You put it in your coffee, your ice cream, your cake, your pancake mix, cream of wheat. When you mix it with the black strap, it tastes like a snickerdoodle or like a cinnamon toast crunch, which is super awesome, okay, ladies? I'm listening. You guys know, the men will get their hands on it, all right? So I'm warning you right now. If you see the bottle empty, it was your husband, okay? All right? Now we're gonna go to the dumping trophy number 7. Anybody want to take a picture here before we leave?
Here,
dumping drop area. What basically happened here was these one thing drop the barrels here. See right here we see this machine. This is actually made for them, for the guys, for the workers here. It's much easier for them to bring the barrels down to the ground. Once you drop down, it will pile up here in the dumping drop area. Which one is here? If you look at Winston, I guess. Alright, comes out kind of muffy after a while, dries up, looks like charcoal. Just so you guys know, we don't use the oak chips for anything. They've been good to use for barbecue. Alright, the smoker. Alright, but they don't package it for anything like that. Because we're basically using rum that we're distilled. That's all we do. As for Jim Beam, they do sell their oak chips. Alright, but we focus more on the rum. We are only wanting the food for Cruiser Mountain. So, alright guys. So moving forward, I don't want you guys getting wet, so I'm going to start right now. Alright, with this section here. Alright, so these trucks here that you see before you, these are filled with the distilled product. Alright, once they finish filling them up, the frame part of the truck gets shipped out to Florida. The Florida Jim Beam crew is waiting to then drive it up to Kentucky, and the Kentucky is waiting bottling, flavoring, and the labeling. Alright, we used to do everything here, but when Jim Beam took over, we took over. Alright, so 15% here, 85% in the States. The only thing is that I'm hearing is that they don't have all of the flavors in some states. So you might have to special order it in an ABC store or such. Here, if you're on vacation, like you guys are today, alright, you're allowed to actually take 6 bottles per person, and it goes through as a free check luggage. Alright guys, there's no better deal than just like that. And we actually have the 6 slot boxes to make it easier for you guys. And when you're ready to leave, you could come in the day before you're leaving and have that package and everything.
You can
for
send
you.
It under, you're saying?
Yeah, they have it under the plane. Alright, and what they do, once you go to the airport, you hand it to them. They'll just make sure, you gotta leave it unsealed because they have to open it to make sure there's no 151 proof rum in there, all right? Which we do have on the island, by the way, but you can't carry it on a plane, it's highly flammable, all right? So once they finish and they check that the bottles are unsealed, so you guys better don't be drinking your rum before it goes in the plane, all right? Because it won't make it back home, so that's why you would see like one slot not there if it's, you know, one of those bottles been half empty. All right, so it has to be like full and properly sealed. All right, so once they've checked it, they close it and they'll tape it. And just so you guys know, it doesn't all have to be Cruisin. I'm not saying that's spider rum, but I'm just letting you know this is one of the other advantages you get. You could put one Cruisin rum and the rest could be wine or anything else, and it's still fine, except the 151
per person.
All right, much cheaper, no taxes here. Just letting you guys know, much easier for you guys. All right. Now, if there's the end of my tour, you guys can go to TripAdvisor. So far.
No, give me some rum.
Give me some rum.
Man, I live here, all right?
And she lives here, man. How good is she not be?
Samples.
Come on, Abby.
And she's giving up.
You should know better than that.
Abby, are we to the top?
Yeah.
Here, Jeff.
Okay, who wanted it filled all the way to the top? Because I knew.
Only. Ready, huh?
Alright. I'll go to the top for me.
Yes, and you can stay with us or with me. And I don't know if you're
okay, so what?
Yes, and you can stay with us or with me. And I don't know if you're
okay, so what do we want?
No, give me some rum.
Give me some rum.
Man, I live here, all right?
And she lives here, man. How good is she not be?
Samples.
Come on, Abby.
And she's giving up.
You
the
should know better than that.
Abby, are we to the top?
Yeah.
Here, Jeff.
Okay, who wanted it filled all the way to the top? Because I knew.
Only. Ready, hon?
Half? All right. All the way to the top?
Yeah.
Or me? Look at my Pearl and my Priscilla. Look how pretty you are. You're just beautiful. Yes, you are. Look at my beautiful girls. Do you like to ride the motorcycle, Pearl? Yes. Look how pretty you are. Look how pretty you are. Are you seeing yourself in the mirror? You seeing yourself in the mirror? Yes, you are. Look. Look, there's my Pearl. There's my Pearl.
So many screwed up with that joke. So many kids are gonna know. Some got them close to me. They got a show that gone. Don't let go, don't let go.
No, push. She farts a little.
I knew. It's just like the girl you had over last
week. She was at the barbecue last night. I can tell by that all that gas.
That's funny how.
Stop it.
I got a grab.
You're not gonna grab her, are you really?
I grabbed her nipple.
Did you?
Yeah.
You're a bad
You got
boy.
It on film. Oh. Hands quicker than I sometimes.
You know, I know she likes you.
Oh, I could, yeah, I could tell she winks.
She looks like she's horny.
You sure?
Yeah. Now I see that, Andy.
You didn't notice she was horny.
She did wink at me, though, seriously. I did see her wink at me.
I've been looking for a woman with horns.
He's so pretty. He's so pretty.
Make sure you hold it. Yeah, go. Turn around and look at the camera so you can be in the movie with it. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, who next?
Look out.
Okay, when you spit out the can, give him the bear quick. Don't get him waiting a long time. When he spit the can out, whoever have a bear, just
okay,
give it to him. You see how I did it?
You don't want to do it.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, but I'll watch them. You tell me if I'm
yeah.
Do it again.
Do it again, but don't forget to look at the camera now.
Make sure you
yeah.
Yeah.
Hold the top, right?
Like yeah.
This. Yeah. Okay.
He chews it up like a piece of gum. Turn around and look. Turn around and look.
Put it in his mouth later, okay?
Make sure you grab it.
If you don't grab it, if you don't grab it, it might drop on the ground and the bear might burst.
Okay.
So go a little closer up for when he finishes.
But Mary, this time you're gonna look at me though when you're doing this.
Yeah, wait. Wait till he spits out.
Wait till he spits it out. Look at me, Mary. Look
yeah,
at me, Mary.
Yeah, look. Look at it. Yeah, yeah.
Oh my God.
Just like this. Good job.
That was fantastic. That was fantastic.
Don't run.
Look at his little eyes are rolling back in his head and everything.
See, Vic look like he done gone to sleep, you know.
Don't forget to turn this way now, Jeff. You got to turn this way. Look at me. You got to look at me.
Look at the camera. You run in. Get closer in.
Get closer
Don't
in.
Don't run. Don't run from the pig.
No, you just get a little bigger. Yeah.
Okay, back up. Once you get a can in your mouth, you can't do anything. You can't bite you anything.
Yeah.
But if you don't have the
You're
can,
so you pretty.
Okay,
you are so pretty. You are so pretty.
Watch it.
You're going to eat your camera.
Hey, come quick.
Come quick. Come
When's
quick.
Gonna, wait.
Still has one in there.
Okay.
Good, go. Turn around. Look at the camera. Look.
Oh, yeah. All yeah, right, yeah.
Mr. Okay. Pig.
Who next? You got any more bags left?
Pig.
Yeah, see, you can pet him like this, but I don't encourage that neither, okay? Because I get him in the mouth. Because I want to do that, right?
Oh, shit. He's so pretty.
Don't pet him, okay?
He's so pretty.
Make sure you hold it. Yeah, go. Turn around and look at the camera so you can be in the movie with him.
Right,
that's what I'm talking about.
Okay,
who next?
Look out.
You got bear, right? Okay, when you spit out the can, give him the bear quick. Don't get him waiting a long time. When you spit the can out, whoever have a bear, just
okay,
give it to him. You see how I did it?
You don't want
to
do it.
You know,
it's okay.
Yeah,
but I'll watch them. You tell me if I'm
yeah.
Gonna,
do it again, but don't forget to look at the camera now.
Make sure you
yeah.
Do
yeah.
Your
Hold the top, right? Like
yeah.
This. Yeah. Okay.
He chews it up like a piece of gum. Turn around
okay,
and look. Turn around and look.
Put it in his mouth like this, okay?
Make sure you grab it.
If you don't grab it, if you don't grab it, it might drop on the ground and the bear might burst.
Okay.
So go a little closer up for when he finishes.
But Mary, this time you're gonna look at me though when you're doing this.
Yeah, wait. Wait till he spits out.
Wait till he spits it out. Look at me, Mary. Look
yeah,
at me, Mary.
Yeah, look. Look at it. Yeah, yeah.
Oh my God.
Just like this. Good job.
That was fantastic. That was fantastic.
Don't run.
Look at his little eyes are rolling back in his head and everything.
See? Vic look like he done gone asleep, you know.
Don't forget to turn this way now, Jeff. You got to turn this way. Look at me. Go look at me.
Look at the camera. You run and get closer in.
Get closer
don't
in.
Run. Don't run from the pig.
No, you just get a little bigger. Yeah.
Okay, back up. Once you get a can in your mouth, you can't do anything. You can't bite you anything.
Yeah.
But if you don't have the can,
you're so pretty.
You are so pretty.
You are so pretty.
Watch it.
You're going to eat your camera.
Hey, come quick.
Come quick.
Wait.
Has one in there.
Okay.
Okay, go. Stand around. Look at the camera. Look.
Oh, yeah. All right, yeah.
Mr.
Okay.
Pig.
Who next? You got any more bags left?
Pig.
Yeah, see, you can pet him like this, but I don't encourage that neither, okay? Okay. I get him in the mouth. You got very much to do that, right?
Up to him, Mary. Mary, walk up to him. He give him a dollar.